Hello, my name is Cody Harrison. I'm an application engineer here at Yokogawa Test & Measurement, and today I'm going to discuss how to get individual phase power measurements in both a Y-connected and Delta-connected system using the Yokogawa WT5000 Precision Power Analyzer. Then we'll discuss how to connect the WT5000 to the free software WT Viewer E-Free and get the same measurements. When we have a three-phase system with a neutral available, we refer to this system as a three-phase four-wire system. This is because we have the three individual phases of the system as well as a neutral as a common voltage reference. In this wiring scheme, the voltages and currents have the same phase relationship. This makes the power calculation simple. Power for the individual phases is just the instantaneous voltage of each leg referenced to neutral multiplied by the instantaneous current for the corresponding phase. Then, to get the total power for the system, we just need to sum P1, P2, and P3. This reference to neutral is also why we refer to this as a Y or star connection, because of the Y or star-like shape of the vector diagram. However, more often than not in motor testing, we do not have a neutral available to reference. In these cases, we have to wire our voltage in a delta connection that will reference the voltage of each phase to another phase. As you can see, when wired in this method, we get line-to-line voltage rather than line-to-neutral voltage. In this wiring configuration, the measured voltage and current do not share the same phase relationship due to the lack of a common reference point, which is the neutral in the three-phase four-wire configuration. Because our voltages are no longer referenced to neutral, our individual power measurements are using those line voltages and will not be measuring the neutral referenced individual phase powers. However, by using KVL, KCL, and Blondel's theorem, the total power for the system can still be accurately measured by summing only two of the wattmeters. In this configuration, P1 and P2 are the wattmeters that will be summed to calculate sigma P. To allow for the correct individual phase power measurements to be calculated, Yokogawa has added the delta computation feature to our latest line of power analyzers. Now we will do a demonstration. Here we have a Yokogawa WT5000 and a three-phase motor that we have set up for demonstrations. This three-phase motor does not have a neutral available to us, which makes it perfect for the 3V3A wiring configuration. We have already wired this system in the 3V3A wiring configuration, and we are now going to walk through the steps to have the WT5000 calculate the individual power for each phase. An example of this wiring method and all other wiring methods for the WT5000 can be found in the WT5000 Getting Started Guide. As we can see in our vector diagram, the voltage is wired in a delta connection and the current is wired in a standard Y connection. Switching to the numeric display, we can see that P1 plus P2 equals sigma AP. We also see that P3 is close to zero. Again, these readings are used in the internal calculations that the WT5000 is performing using Blondel's transformation and are not valid individual power measurements. To get the correct individual measurements, we will use the delta computation functions that will perform the appropriate calculations and give us the correct individual powers. Now we are going to walk through setting up the delta computation functions on a WT5000. This process will be very similar on other Yokogawa power analyzers. We will start in the numeric matrix view, but the steps for any of the other views will be similar. First, we will select Display, then select Items. We will then select the first item we want to change. For our setup, it will be the seventh item down. Then we will select the Function drop-down menu and scroll down to select Measure. Here we can select from all of our available delta functions. We will select delta P1. We will then repeat these steps for two more rows to display our delta P2 and P3 measurements. We can now see our individual phase powers in row 7, 8, and 9. And if we sum these, we can see that they are approximately equal to the total power for our sigma A three-phase system. We will now connect to our WT5000 using the WT Viewer E-Free software. With the USB connection, we see that the software automatically finds the WT5000. Once the software has found our WT5000, we will select the Start Online Connection button. We will then select the measure display of the WTViewer E-Free software. Once in the measure display, we will select the numeric item button and make sure that the delta measure box is checked. We can then select one of our function drop-down boxes to select the delta P option from our function list. Be sure that the element group selected is the one we have our three-phase system on. As we can see, the delta P values are being collected. I hope that you find this video helpful in setting up your WT5000 precision power analyzer to measure individual phase powers in both a Y-connected and delta-connected system. Remember, the setup for other Yokogawa power analyzers with the delta computation function will be very similar. For more information, or if you have any questions, please visit tmi.yokogawa.com. And don't forget to click subscribe to join our YouTube channel. Thank you for watching.